prospectors. I'm a little late on the patch notes today as a result of the affiliate streaming drops event yesterday. Unfortunately, I just was doing that. I didn't wasn't able to get to this ahead of time. I do apologize, but here it is. Let's jump into the patches. The changes refined our anti-cheat algorithm even further. More efficiency, less false positives. That's good. I personally don't know anybody that, you know, has been banned falsely, but it's awesome that they are working on that. I'm sure that really sucks for the people that are. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. Let me know if you have any, know anybody or what happened with that situation. DevNote, in our efforts to tune our anti-cheat algorithm further, several players ended up facing a ban despite not using any cheating tool. We deeply apologize for that and are making sure to unban any and all innocent players. That's beautiful. These changes will ensure the false positives won't happen again while acting ever more swiftly whenever an actual cheater is detected. It's a never-ending battle, as with all online games, but we're sure we can get this. Awesome. Beautiful that they're trying. I'm really sorry to use those of you who got banned. Hopefully we can forgive them. I personally would if I was you guys, but I appreciate that. We switched our player support tool and transitioned over to a new one. If you report someone sent a ticket within the game, it will arrive at a new tool. This will help us process requests more smoothly with no replies getting lost anymore. We will shut down the old tool after some days and the requests and data was sent to that will be directly deleted completely. That's beautiful. Awesome that they're getting a better support system. I know the other ones, most of the time we just contact the community managers. Otherwise, it's like not hasn't been great. They implemented the one system. I think that's what they're talking about getting rid of, though. So I'm really glad they're putting something new in there. It's beautiful for everybody to be able to report easier. Performance and stability should have increased overall. We're always looking for improvements. Beautiful. I know that last patch weirdly kind of my performance went down for some reason. So hopefully this reverts that. Supply crates can't be opened anymore while your stash is full. Fair enough. I didn't know that was a thing. I wonder if people were losing their stuff. Let me know in the comments if anybody was losing their stuff. I'm just curious. Pressing the escape key and Fortuna Pass will now take you back to the rewards page instead of closing the menu completely. Fair enough. Pushed back the first wall in the Crusher Cavern so players mining that wall can't be blown up too easily from a blind grenade throw. That's beautiful, actually, because I was thinking about that while I was hitting the wall. I was like, dude, we could be all grenaded right now and literally nothing you could do. That's awesome. For balancing, the Lancerator has reduced recoil and removed damage fall off. That's interesting. I'm really curious to see how this plays out. It's going to make the Lancerator a really good DMR, in my opinion. KBR long shot, remove damage fall off. Interesting. That's really going to be curious. And the Basilisk removed damage fall off. This is going to be crazy for those team fights, man. I'm really interested to see how this plays out. Let me know what you guys think in the comments about these changes for the balancing. These are only balance changes for today as we wanted to focus on more pressing matters first and foremost. As you will be able to see in the upcoming bug fixes, we have been diligent in trying to gather as much data and feedback about weapon balance as possible though. Among other changes, we want to make SMGs better, low tier shotguns a bit less too good, and higher tier equipment slightly more appealing. In other words, expect a lot of balancing in the next update. I love that they're saying this. I really hope that they do. They kind of keep saying this, and I really appreciate the dev team. I think they're doing a great job, but I think that they're giving us a little bit of hope when they should just, you know, say it's going to take some time. You know, I want everybody to realize it is going to take some time. So I really am glad that they're working diligently, and I think they're doing great. I just think they need to put that in there for everybody. Bug fixes. We fixed an issue where the shop would show incorrect prices for certain currencies. I had no idea that was a thing, but good to know it's fixed. Fixed an issue that would prevent XP gain for the Fortuna Pass. This is really awesome because personally, I don't know if they fixed what I think they fixed, but I've been struggling. I have all the quests done, and then every day I go in there and my kills and stuff are already done, and I haven't even started. So I don't know. Applied a few fixes to prevent communication issues with our servers on the station when claiming stuff, selling things, etc. Nice. That's good. I know we've all ran into those small little issues here or there. One time in the beta, I lost a ton of money. Fortunately, I sold like a really big sell and lost it all. So hopefully they fix some. Anything like that is good. Fix some server desync where creatures could get a good swipe on you despite their animation showing otherwise. they've got strong minds, sure, but it's been much. That's awesome. I've seen the Jeffs, you know, hit you and they're not even looking at you, and a couple other creatures obviously too. So let's hope that this fixes that. It'll be beautiful because everybody definitely gets upset, especially those Jeffs that hurt, you know. No more dropping an invisible drop pod. You're not superheroes, damn it. I didn't know that was a thing, but that's good. Fix an issue that would make sprays appear a lot less shiny than they ought to. I didn't know that that was a big thing, but that's awesome. Creatures will now perfectly emit their death rattles when killed by melee attack, so you can start feeling bad about yourself again. Fair enough. I didn't really realize that was still an issue, or that was ever an issue, but cool. Smooth out the world here and there so bullets don't get stuck on magic pixels. Fair enough. I'm not really, you know, I can't visualize that right now, but it's good overall for the game, obviously. Fix the Savage Marauder taking as much damage as standard Marauder instead of being more resilient. Yeah, I know. It was a nice bug, but that's life. Honestly, I never personally, you know, encountered that bug, but that's good. You know, we thought rattlers were a bit too hyper-focused. Now, they will now hesitate less to switch targets as they see fit. That's good because, dude, they'll chase you across the map, you know, sometimes, and it's just a little bit much how far they'll chase you. I'm not saying it's good because I guess they're just switching between your teammates, but I don't know. It'd be cool to have them get off you once in a while. Contracts and missions should not show as duplicates anymore. One thing at a time. Nice. Elite Crushers will now make sure to have an applicable path before initiating a charge. This shall bonk their heads no more. Nice. That's good. And the Crusher's movement all around is kind of buggy and wonky, so I'm really hoping they fix the entire Crusher thing. Let me know what you guys think in the comments if you guys witnessed any weird stuff or died to any of that or anything like that. Fix an issue that prevented users from closing their friends list. Fair enough. I have not had that issue, but I know the friends list has been terror for everybody, so we're glad to get some changes there. Progress is now updated properly on your to-do list as you completed tasks. Nice. Maybe that's what I was getting before, is a visual bug for not getting it, but I don't know. I'm really not sure, to be honest, so that's good. We had a stern talk with factions. The supply crates shouldn't contain items over low quality than what they were supposed to grant anymore. Okay, that's good. I mean, because realistically, a lot of the supply crates are just not worth it. So it's good that they're up in that. Fix some issues where campaign missions couldn't be turned in once complete. I never experienced that, but that would be super frustrating. So I'm really glad they fixed that. Fixed a quick exploit that allowed skipping the Shatterguns reloading animation. That's interesting, because the one thing I noticed with that is if you pick something up, it would cancel it instantly and it would still reload. So I'm not sure if that's what they're talking about or something else, but either way. Keep that in there. No more using emotes to loot containers through walls. Clever, but that's still cheating. That's really interesting. Who knew that was a thing? I heard about it yesterday, and I can't believe people come up with this stuff, but it's good that it's fixed. Weapon attachments can now be insured with gear salvage insurance before dropping. I'm not really sure exactly how that works. So they changed the way you could take on and put on attachments on insurance. Before you couldn't, now you can. So I'm not really fully sure on that. Pressing tab in the Fortuna Pass menu shouldn't break anything now. Good, good. The skip button for timers was something grayed out for no reason. That shouldn't happen anymore. That's good. I don't really know what timers exactly they're talking about, to be honest with you, but that's really good that it's fixed. Miscellaneous. Timers can now be skipped at the very last second, preventing unnecessary loss of resources and some issues from occurring. I really don't understand what this means by timers can't be skipped at the very last second. I really don't know. I'm super confused on what timers we're talking about. I don't know. I'm not sure. All head variations can now be previewed in the shop when looking for a new prospector. Nice. Updated our localization for a few languages. Nice, that's beautiful. Get more people in the game, game grows more. We all love it, right? Known issues. Vanity items cannot be claimed if the stash is full. Biker Queen's image shows black hair, though she has white hair. That's interesting. All right, guys, well, that's it for the patch notes. I really appreciate all you guys watching. Make sure to like, subscribe, check me out on Twitch. Thank you so much, guys. Take it easy.